It's been a while since I played a game that had simulator in the title. This is MTB Downhill Simulator. I couldn't work out what the hell that was. I just realised the word simulator is not on this main screen. But apparently it's that biking thing. It looks like, from what I can tell, a first-person cycling simulator. And it's developed by Dev4Play. Dev4Play. Which is an interesting name. They're interesting people because they've released four games on Steam in the past month or so. I think it's a month and 2 weeks. So that's a bit interesting. Ooh, hello. Ooh, we can change the language. English. German. Click and see enter. We got Polish. Polish. We got Spanish. Presna enter. It's like press enter. Russian. Yes. Portuguese. Pressoni. Pressioni enter. French. Press enter. Still no language. And whoopsie-daisies, Turkish, basin enter. That just sounds cool. That's like, yeah, it's basin enter. That's what the youths talk about. English, please. English, please. English. Ah. German it is, then. Oh, this is where they're hiding the music. Okie dokie. Right. Do we want to go to the shop? Do we want to go to the Bend End? Do we want to go to the Karte Auswahlen? Or do we want to Mitwork? Is that credits? Oh, look at me knowing words. There's the word fog just sitting there that doesn't go away. That's interesting. Should we do this one? Because it's biggest. Fuck me, that is a Unity level select screen if I've ever seen one. Level one. It's apparently Ladder for Gra- Is that loading? Or is that the name of the level? Okay, I guess that was loading. Right. Click and see W zum. Oh god. A bzwert the zum. Oh shit. Yeah, there we go. We are skating. Well, not skating. Cycling. Oh, it's very jumpy. Oh. What the fuck's happened? I appear to have fallen off my bike. Mitten den Tasten 1, 2, 3, und 5. Fuck you, 4. Auf dem Ziffernblock. What does that even mean? Is my bike going weird at the base? It seems to be jolting around. Right, apparently P does something and numbers 1, 2, 3, and 5 do something. I don't know what they're doing. Number two made me lean forward a bit, so maybe that's the lean forward button. Well, that's doing the same as W, though. Stop, 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 stop. All right, good. Well, I've cycled myself into a very interesting situation here. I just wanted to know what 1, 2, 3, 5 did. 2 just drives me forwards. 2 is the same as W. Oh, now I've died. What is happening? Right, let's try this again. That way, then that way. Bit of a turn. And now I live in a tree. You know what? I'm going to restart this game and put it in English. Ah, there we go. It resets by default back to English every single time you play. Marvelous. Choose level, shop, and exit. Fog's still there. Credits and back. Right. Choose level. Level 1. Loading. Right. Please tutorialize me. Please tutorialize me. There we go. Press W to drive, A to turn left. Why is that format completely different? D is turn right, space is break. I swear there was an F. Huh. So space is break. Return to last checkpoint is R. Right enter is slow motion. Right enter. So you mean enter, not return. I love that just stops all your momentum as well, but still lets you turn. Use the keys 1, 2, 3, and 5 on the numeric keypad to control the position of the driver. I think I just died. Right, I've restarted and I'm playing, but that thing's still there. So it's one, so it's forwards, backwards, left a bit, right a bit. Okay, so we have to, that's why the slow motion's on the right enter. Okay, good. Oh, well, okay, so it's not motorbikes. I don't want my knees next to the ground. Oh, so when I got confused that 2 on the number pad was just putting me forward, that's because 2 on the number pad was literally just putting me forward. For some reason they mapped it there. Oh, what's happened? Why is that bit of my bike just falling off? Ooh, I don't think this is how... Wow, the fucking inner ear on this guy to be able to do this. Yeah, that was impressive. Collect parts and unlock new bikes and clothes. Gotcha. P doesn't continue. Oh, shit. Okay, so now I've actually fallen over to the point where I'm in the grass, but I'm still going with my ludicrously long arms. Whoop. Wow, look at... Okay, ignore the shutter, but look at that mountain range in the distance. I actually have god rays through it and not spawn properly. Oh, I can't go forward at the moment. Why can't I go forwards? I'm stuck in something, I think. I'm stuck in something. Yeah, that is some... Oh my god, that is some fucking explosively shit popping. Oh my god, that is... terrible. That's popping out as well as in. There she goes. Right, tilt a bit around here. Nice. Beautiful god rays, beautiful god rays. Well, there's a thing to collect. Thing to collect. What's that? That fuzz. Apparently I collected a bit of fuzz. Oh, jump. Not a jump. Oh, fucking hell. Something appeared in my front of my face for a second then. Ah, down the valley. There we go. Everything's fine. I may be slightly off course. And in a tree. Man, I've died. Oh, big jump here. Oh, I've got to remember to turn in the way I want it to go. Oh, that was possibly good. Don't know. I don't think I'm going to have a great lap time here, considering I've stopped the throw up twice. Oh, tilting my way into the turns. But yeah, the game, when you land on a bit of terrain, the bike doesn't sort of fit to it. You sort of have to tilt yourself to it. Like, you can go up any bit of terrain like this, which just feels strange. Come on, wheelie up, wheelie up, wheelie up, wheelie up, wheelie up. Go, go, go! As the mountain in front of you explodes, go! Wheelie! Just wheelie! That seems magic. Oh, that time I fell down for the following reasons. Ready? Full speed, full speed, full speed, full speed! Pump it, pump it, pump it! Yeah, you don't actually get enough speed to go up the hill from this restart point, so I'll actually have to reverse. And there isn't a reverse key, there's just a massive juddery, shaky death key. Interesting design choices. Okay, got a lot more speed at that time, and I want to get off my bike. I want to get off the bike and just walk and pull it up. That would make so much more sense. Bollocks to you! I'm going back this way! Okay, I've gone super far back to try and get up as much speed as absolutely possible, because, can't seem to make it up this hill. Okay, turn around this corner, ride the corner, ride the corner. I feel like I massively slowed down there, and I've got really no further than I normally do. Trying to go sideways to get a bit more space, speed, no. I just wiggle. Hold the brake down, okay. No. Okay. Slow motion burn! Fast motion! Slow motion, no motion. I'm stuck on level fucking one at this point. Computer's starting to overheat. It's clearly because this game is incredibly and exceptionally taxing. Okay, I've got a new plan. This is a new cunning course of action. It's called, if I line myself up sideways and then do a stoppy, it seems to force you into weird physics. So maybe I can stoppy my way up here and gain momentum by stoppying constantly. It's working! Speed! 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 Oh, we're tilting slightly. Come on, tilt back, tilt back. Speed! 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 Yeah! That's how we do it. We just have to stoppy all the time. Good. Puzzle solved. Oh, down a big hill, down a big hill, down a big hill, through the trees, through the trees, through the trees. And there's no collision. You can only fall over by going sideways. You can't fall over by, for instance, smashing into a tree at 60 miles per hour on a bike. Oh, fuck, I fell off my fucking bike. Ah, oh, fucking here again. Hang on a second. Stoppy. Oh my god, stoppy boost! I'm now a speedrunner. I've developed a speedrun majig. There we go. Right, oh my god, there's the speed boost from the stoppy run. As I like to call it now, it's a very stoppy run I'm having right now. Okay, right, we're hitting trees. Oh my god, look at that. There's some sort of vortex to another plane in front of me. Ooh, hang on, let's stoppy into it. Stoppy. Oh, I tried to touch it. And I felt like something touched me back. Must be the molester dimension. I get that cycling is half turning the handlebars and mostly shifting your body weight around, but it feels very awkward because that, I don't know what I need to do to fix that. I don't know if it's going to auto-reset that. If like I land on a bank that's sideways while being in this direction, I just stay up like that or I pop into an entirely different place. I don't know what's going on. Well, I found a thing. What's the thing? Ah! Level completed. Back to menu. Okay. Good. Let's go to the shop. See what we can buy. Okay, so there's loads of different bikes that we can jump through. How do I select one? Do I have to get all the bits for it or something? What's all this? Is that all the bits for it? Oh, that's the one I can have. Good. Okay, and then we've got other clothes. That's good. Orange because of reasons. And then gloves. Right. So it's... Okay. Okay. There isn't a message there. Just has the world's tiniest okay. Okay, I am stuck on this menu. Yeah, stuck. Oh, I just realized you can right click to randomly zoom in, and that turns the lighting on for that block at the back there. So that's something I found while being completely trapped in this fucking place. Ah, there we go. Even though I had the gloves equipped, I have to equip the gloves again. Otherwise, it won't let me leave. Right, ooh, look, a new jersey to wear. Yeah, I got me some Evo. Right, tilt round here, tilt round here. Ooh, nice. And then there's the world's smallest hot air balloon on our right there. Tilt round here, tilt round here. Nice. Come around here. There's no... Ow. Well, there's a big crash there. There's no times, as far as I can see. It's just sort of a survival thing, which is strange. I thought this would have been a time thing. Oh, no. God damn me for going through that tape. Right, let's cut across here, because... You know what? Let's not do that. Let's not do that. Seems like it won't work. Don't know why. Just got a hunch. I keep hitting S to brake, but brake is on spacebar for some reason. And not the convenient place where everything already is and is manipulating, so... Good. Well, now I'm stuck under there, and now I've been flung across the world. That's not tape, actually. That's fucking bungee cord! Gently through here, brake. Gently through, gently through, gently through. Gently through, gently through, gently through, gently through. Don't go down there! That bungee tape is death! Quick, stoppy your way back up the hill! Stoppy, 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 stoppy. Whee! Alright, I'm just gonna fuck the course and go down these bits. They seem safer. Also, that mountain on fire for some reason. Oh, what the fuck? That's enough to make me fall over. And why am I just a severed head when I fall off? Why am I being decapitated every single time I fuck up? That's a hell of a harsh punishment. Oh yeah, this is definitely the quicker and more convenient way. Just gotta wiggle off the tree every now and then. Also, the gold bit on my bike kind of looks like a Japanese cartoon character for like children. It's like a happy toilet or something. Look at him. Hello, I'm the happy toilet. Oh, that mountain's still exploding over there. Does somebody want to tell the developers the sun can't shine through a mountain? Here's a fun game I like to call Watch the Trees at the End of the Valley. Boots, 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 boots. Yes, they are the boots trees. Whoa, what the fuck? And now they're loading in some way. My god, this game's draw distance is the same length as Rupert Murdoch's dry and shriveled penis. I don't want to make a big thing about it, but I distinctly think that that rabbit is on fire. Doesn't Unity have a box we can just tick it and be like, yeah, don't shine the sun through solid things, thanks. Hang on a second, wait. Right, so the sun, if I can aim and look at it, is over there. Then why is all this bit lit up? In fact, why are these trees on the left here lit up from like they're from above? There's a... Why are there two suns? Is this game so fucking Tatooine? And down the thing, and level completed. Joy. Ooh, that's an ominous start. As opposed to the last fucking 40 minutes I've recorded. Right, there's a thing. I like the collectibles just immediately in front of you. Good, thanks. I got me some wood. Right, so this one is a much more difficult stay in the boundaries kind of one. I didn't turn. And now I'm... Oh. Brought off some trees. And then there was thunder. Maybe the god of simulators is angry with me. Then again, if it was god of simulators, I'd be angry at this fucking game. I like how every time you respawn in front of you, there's just a noose just dangling off the ceiling. As if to say, you'll be back. Oh my god. If you hit these edge bits here at speed, I think they're fine when you're quite slow. But if you hit them at speed, that's just game over. You just lose that part. So it's actually better if you can get off the terrain. You're less likely to die. Oh. Bomber sent his drones over. There goes an Afghan family. Right, what else is... Bloody hell, what else is in this place we start at? Quick turnaround, quick turnaround, quick turnaround. I want to see if there's anything else in here. Oh, does this not even exist? Oh, for fuck's sake, it doesn't even exist! Speed running, motherfucker! Oh shit, does any of this exist? Do I even exist? Hang on. Ow! Yes. What about this bit here as we respawn? Nope, doesn't exist. Right, none of there's any of that. Right, so there's the door to the front. We go out there and there's the sun. If we now turn to the left down here and slow ourselves down so we can, whoops-a-daisies, go through this bridge just here. So at 90 degrees to the left, there's the sun again. Why? Right, does this wall exist? Yes, that wall exists. Good, so with a bit of a... wheeling skill, we can turn around here. And then, see, this is quite difficult because there's no reverse. There we go. Okay, so if we now shoot off in this direction, and then rock and roll over here. Ooh, rocks exist. There's another fucking Sev sunlight over it. Is there literally? Oh my god, I can actually see right to the very corners of the map. This is amazing. But there is literally fucking god rays on every side. That's just silly. And that's that bit I just crashed at. That's right near the end of the level, I assume. So I can just skip it all. Or fall down a mountain. Okay, and turn and go. Ooh, there appears to actually be something that exists here. Which is proving a bit difficult to get over. Oh, now bounced off. And I'm going in here. Oh my god, the sun was struck by lightning! Actually, I don't think this one would give a shit if it was struck by lightning. Right, those rocks are actually pretty tricky to navigate, considering you're not actually supposed to be navigating on them. So I'm going to go up here, and then at this point, I'm going to turn left. I don't know if you're supposed to actually come up here or not. Because you go down like this little bit here, and then it's sort of a bit... There's a way over here. And then you just keep going over in this direction, over here. Like, there's a lot of random shit here that literally has no purpose. And then doobie-doobie-doo. Yeah, there's the course. So, what the bloody hell is with the fucking 80% of this level that someone's modelled for literally no apparent reason? Is this entire fucking map a Unity asset? Oh, hang on a second. Hang on, is the game still playing in the background? Do I have to pause the game from here, or is that music? Oh, next. Oh, there was music. Wow, so you can play music. Yeah, let's not do that. Up the hill. Ooh, yeah. Okay. Round the terrifying graveyard. Ooh, definitely round the terrifying graveyard. And then, which way? Ooh, over this little rampy thing. Steady on, steady on, steady on, steady on, steady on, steady on. I guess we're going down that pier. Oh, God. Could we just pop over that? Yep, there's a load of cobwebs and shit there. Massive cobwebs. Oh, there's a big wall in the way. Not entirely sure I'm actually going to be able to get around there now because I can't reverse. Oh! Hey! Thank you, physics. What the what? Physics bugs! Okay, and I made it to the pier! And that's just the end of the level. Just ends on the pier. Marvellous. Let's do one more. And then never, ever, 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 ever play this again. All right, I got the speed going. I got the speed going. Bit of a tilt over there. Oh, here comes a jump. Here comes a jump. Here comes a jump. Here comes exciting momentum of a jump. Whoa, so exciting. Oh, here comes another jump. A little bit better line for that one. Yeah, tupper, 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 tupper to you too. I enjoy the trees in the background that don't have the fog effect on them, so they stand out like a motherfucker. Always fun. Steady, steady. Oh, I think I've fallen off. Quickly, do the stoppy cheat majig thing. Rev, rev, rev. Sorry, I was just calling for my friend to come over. He's a reverend. This game needs some fucking holy water. All right, I am now pretty reasonably convinced that my shadow doesn't actually have a head. Can't see a head on that shadow down there. I think it's, yeah, there's a very long arm. I don't think there's a head because they've cut the head off so you can see out the player's eyes. Ooh, hang on. If we turn sharply here, turn, 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 turn. Whee! We are free to explore whatever the hell's down here. Oh, shit. You know what's down here? It's just more of the game. Ooh. Ooh, found a big ramp. And apparently I'm revving a motorbike on it. So that's... Beautifully made. Oh, now I'm stuck. Ah, the fucking game respawned me down here. Boo! But I don't do this bit again. Ready, and lean. And keep the speed, and lean. Oh, got some air. Oh, now I'm stuck between some rocks. Oh my god, that doesn't actually stop there. And now my arm is stuck between two rocks. Gonna have to chew that off. Whee! Backflip! Oh, so, you just die if you go over the back. There's no actual stunting or anything. That just kills you dead. And no flip. Oh god, how am I supposed to make that much speed? Oh, now I'm fucking digging a hole to fucking hell. Hey, I'm gonna leave him to it. It's a long way to hell. Although there are trains there every 5 minutes from Basildon. The Nerd³. The Nerd³. The Nerd who? The Nerd³. Oh, another classic video from the national treasure that is Nerd³. Anyway, I was just looking on the old Steam page to see if I can buy another game that these people have made, because surely there's some hilarity to be had there. This is MTB Downhill Simulator, so let's go to the developer and see what other things they've made. Right, so they've made Tower Defense Ultimate, Rover the Dragon Slayer, War Truck Simulator, and MTB Downhill Simulator. 27th of May, 10th of June, 2nd of June, 17th of June. They're releasing them once a week, by the look of it, for a short month there. Interesting. Hang on a second. Mixed reviews, but these are all positive reviews. Huh, let's have a look at the other simulator they've got there. Mostly positive. That's interesting. Let's have a quick look through here. Operate manual gearbox. Oh yeah, well that's still got that fair bit of horrific popping and stuff, and doesn't look super great. I mean, there's massive popping stuff going on here. Don't know what that's supposed to be showing me. There's a well, that one's set in the glowing sea, and on this one the skybox isn't working. There's no fog on it, so it's standing out like anything. Right, why has it got positive reviews? It doesn't look super great. We just have a scroll around. Not recommended. Joke review. I demand DLC, says this person. I'll open them up in a new tab. Since I was a kid, always wanted to drive military truck on training ground. Thank you guys for fulfillment of one of my dreams. Interesting. Wow, for this price, I have so much fun. The manual gearbox is great and the look of the game is not so bad. I would recommend. Wow, fascinating. A new idea. Cool realization. Some interesting ideas. Quite a good price. Summary, it is okay. Oh, let's have a look at these people there. So this is, oh, this is weird. This person's only reviewed three games, and all three of those games are by the same developer. How strange. What about this one? Well, this person has reviewed the first four games this person has reviewed is all from that developer, and then the game Massive for some reason there. Interesting. What about this one? Again, it's those four games. And again on this one. It's the same games by the same developer. All positive reviews from all of them as well. Now, that's just a coincidence. Yeah.